Good morning, everybody. Manny here on the planet. And today we are into the well. We're well into the taper now. By 3-4 days, something like that. We've got about 10 days out from the marathon from Chester. So in the taper, I'm reducing the volume. And we're probably going to run about 60 kilometers this week, maybe about 30, 35-ish next week. Just getting the mileage down a bit. But we've still got some workouts. Today's workout is going to be 22 kilometers with 2 8-kilometer stints in it at 4:30 pace, which is the marathon goal pace. And although reducing the load, we'll be keeping the intensity up there pretty much. There will be a bit of easy running, but the easy runs will finish probably with kind of marathon goal pace effort or something a little bit faster. So today we're going to have a big workout. Probably have another big workout one day next week, and then the other ones will be like workouts close to home, and just obviously reducing the mileage down. So yeah, it's a decent day for it. It's been raining. I thought as I was driving down here down to the quayside, I thought the rain was going to be quite bad. It's actually stopped now and it's relatively dry, so should be a good workout. Hopefully the rain stays off. Doesn't matter if it starts late, because it's probably going to be like that in Chester anyway, isn't it? So right, I'll have a 2k warm-up, and then we'll do a stint of 8, and then we'll have another go at that, and it should be quite good to keep it at 4:30 pace. Start now in the taper, right up until, you know, 10 days up to Chester, I'm actually only going to run 5 days, and that's running every other day. Obviously reducing load, so already I'm starting to feel a bit fresher. Right, let's get to it. There it is, that's the first set done. Our first stint of 8 kilometers at 4:30 marathon goal pace. Whew. It's more like 4:31, 4:32, but I'll take that. It's a bit more humid than I thought, and for whatever reason, I had to work a bit harder than I expected. But, yeah, not bad. Let's have a cool down for a couple of K now. And then we'll go again. Okay, so that's the workout complete, and wasn't too good really in the second stint. The first stint was great, 4:30-ish, and then the second stint came in at about, I'm not sure exactly what it'd be, but somewhere in the region of about 4:45 or something like that. I was just didn't have the energy to keep it going. I think it's because it feels a bit humid today. It's not really that warm, it's not cold, but it's not warm. My t-shirt is waterlogged because I did have some rain through the stints, but it's yeah, there's no real excuses for the conditions. It's just I just didn't have it today. So trying to do two stints of 4:30 pace, it's quite tough. The first one wasn't too bad, to be fair, like it wasn't too bad, but trying to contemplate running 4:30 minutes per kilometer for a whole marathon. Okay, I will be fresher when that comes around, and I have only just started the taper, but that was tough. But nevertheless, the effort was there. Even though the pace wasn't there, the heart rate would have been up there in the second stint. All the data's there on Strava if you want to go and take a look. So what's happening? So we've done 2k warm-up plus 17:19, so I've got a 3k. We now about half a kilometer, so about 2.5k left to do on the cool down, and get some of this recovery mix in. Don't use a recovery mix all the time, just mainly after the big workouts. So obviously it was a really, really long run, 30-35k long run, probably even 25k long run, I love the recovery mix, and this is a mix of my protein and a little bit of Unived in there. I've had a, for the hardest of workouts, I'll just put full Unived in there. And obviously after a race, like I did the Great North Run recently, I put full Unived in. But yeah, it's a lovely day down the quayside, like. Couldn't have asked for more in terms of conditions. All right, you did feel the wind going one way a little bit. But walking around, it's not too bad. Really nice overcast and the sun. So I couldn't really ask for better conditions in that respect. Just a little bit humid. So thank you very much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.